सो हे गाइज एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ PIB 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द PIB न्यूज विच आर बेनिफिशियल फॉर द ESI सेक्शन ऑफ RBI ग्रेट बी एंड अबाउट। तो चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं आज का सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन इफ यू आर कमिंग हेयर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम डू सब्सक्राइब टू आर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेस एंड अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द डेली सेशंस। ऑलराइट, so let's begin with the very first question, which says which of the following banks has organized a virtual seminar on social infrastructure financing and use of digital technologies in collaboration with the department of economic affairs of india। kaun sa in panchon mein se kaun sa international bank hai jisne ek virtual seminar organize kiya tha in collaboration with the department of economic affairs and that virtual seminar guys was based on social infrastructure financing and use of digital technologies। okay, so let's talk about this news। so the department of economic affairs and new development bank, or you can also say the BRICS bank, it is also known as the BRICS banks, and remember new development bank, the president is Mr. Marcos Prado Troijo, and he is from Brazil। all right, so this bank and department of economic affairs have organized a virtual seminar on social infrastructure financing and the use of digital technologies, how we can enhance the financing in the social infrastructure sector and how we can use the digital technologies to enhance the social infrastructure। so basically ye is seminar ka basic objective tha, and it was organized as a part of economic and financial cooperation agenda under the Indian BRICS chairship of 2021। if you remember in the year 2021 each and every event of BRICS will be organized by india। sare ke sare events jo honge BRICS ke wo sare kaun organize karega, india karega। matlab 2021 ki presidency jo hai BRICS ki wo kiske paas hai, india ke paas hai। right, and the seminar was focused on key issues surrounding the social infrastructure financing and the use of digital technologies, this we have already discussed। and remember isme se jo is news me se jo important part hai wo itna hi hai ki what was the basic objective of this seminar and which organization organized this, that is it, department of economic affairs of india and the new development bank of india। and what was the objective, what was the topic of discussion, it was social infrastructure financing and the use of digital technologies। but for a basic understanding let's talk about what were the topics of the discussion। number 1, what is the importance of investing in social infrastructure and how this investment can promote the sustainable development। number 2, what are the steps for tackling the challenges related to social infrastructure financing, kya kya challenges hain। number 3, what are the ways to de-risk the projects to enhance the private sector participation in the social infrastructure। we can see that in the social infrastructure there is a very less participation of private sector, so to enhance that participation there were some discussions, the value of integrating digital technologies into social infrastructure to enhance the delivery of health and education in the post COVID era, and explore the range of viable models and instruments for financing social infrastructure in the 5 BRICS countries। all right, so these were some of the topics of the discussion, these are not important for the exam, ye sab yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai, you don't have to remember all this, just these are just for the basic understanding that what were the main topics for the discussion during the seminar, and this seminar was organized by new development bank, therefore guys the option B new development bank is the correct answer। asian development bank guys chairperson is mr masatsugu asakawa is the chairperson, new development bank as I told you Marcos Prado Troijo, asian infrastructure investment bank it's mr Jin Liken, इसके अलावा वर्ल्ड बैंक वी ऑन लो डेविड मैलपस एंड यूरोपियन इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंक इट्स मिस्टर हर्नी और इट्स वर्नी WERNEY। नाउ यू हैव टू टेल मी द हेडक्वार्टर्स, नाउ यू हैव टू टेल मी द हेडक्वार्टर्स ऑफ ऑल दीज बैंक, आई हैव टोल्ड यू द चेयरपर्सन और द प्रेसिडेंट, नाउ यू हैव टू टेल मी द हेडक्वार्टर्स ऑफ ऑल दीज बैंक, प्लीज राइट डाउन इन द कमेंट्स। and now let's move ahead to question number 2। recently IREDA has been conferred with the green urja award to excel green financing, by which organization this award has been conferred to IREDA ko green urja award mila hai, to hame batana hai ki kaun si organization ne award diya hai। right, so indian renewable energy development agency limited has been conferred with green urja award by indian chamber of commerce, remember this दिस इज आईसीसी इन शॉर्ट एंड रिमेंबर एंड दिस इज ऑफकोर्स नॉट इंटरनेशनल क्रिकेट काउंसिल, इट इज इंडियन चैम्बर ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड दिस गाइज एजेंसी इज अ मिनी रत्ना, इट इज अ मिनी रत्ना एंड इट वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ न्यू एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी विच इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर आर के सिंह. राइट, मिस्टर आर के सिंह इसके मिनिस्टर है एंड इट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द ईयर 1987 में एस्टैब्लिश हुआ था एंड इट इज द ओनली एजेंसी, इट इज द ओनली एजेंसी टू फाइनेंस रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी प्रोजेक्ट्स इन आर कंट्री. केवल अकेली हमारे देश में एजेंसी ऐसी है जो कि रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी या फिर कोई ऐसी एनर्जी रिलेटेड जो प्रोजेक्ट्स होते हैं जो कि यू नो ग्रीन सेक्टर से रिलेटेड है तो उनको फाइनेंस करने का, उनको लोन देने के लिए एक अकेली एजेंसी है. राइट, एंड बाय दिस अवार्ड हैज बीन कन्फर्ड सो फॉर बीइंग द लीडिंग पब्लिक इंस्टीट्यूशन इन फाइनेंसिंग इंस्टीट्यूशन फॉर रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी दिस ईयर. सो जनरली यही ये अवार्ड जो है इसी एजेंसी को ही मिलता है. एंड फॉर द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2020-21 विच मीन्स द प्रीवियस फाइनेंशियल ईयर IRDA disbursed a whooping ₹8827 crores as a loan for the green finance. Okay, green sector में 8,827 crore rupees as a loan दिया था IRDA ने in the previous financial year of 2020-21. Okay, and these are some basic information about IRDA. It was established in 1987 and remember IRDA has over the years sanctioned loans aggregating to ₹96,601 crores, disbursed ₹63,492 crores and supported more than 17,586 megawatt of renewable energy capacity in the country till date. इतने सारे facts याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है, but yes, ये दिखाता है कि IRDA is working exceptionally well. And who is the CMD? It's Mr. Pradeep Kumar Das. Mr. PK Das is the current CMD of IRDA. Okay. So therefore, guys, the correct answer should be what? It's option D, ICC, Indian Chamber of Commerce, because the question is which organization has conferred this award. Indian Chamber of Commerce is the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 3, which is about another approval of a PLI scheme. So you have to consider the following statements regarding PLI scheme, National Program on Advanced Chemistry Cell Battery Storage, and you have to identify the correct statement. So there is one more PLI scheme that has been approved by the Union Cabinet, which is known as National Program on Advanced Chemistry Cell Battery Storage, with a total outlay of ₹18,100 crore. 18,100 crore का total outlay है. Now, what are these advanced chemistry cell? Advanced chemistry cell होते क्या है? So these are guys new generation storage technologies that can store electricity either in the electrochemical form or the chemical form. Electrochemical या फिर chemical form में energy store की जा सकती है. And it can be converted back into electrical energy as and when required. So these are the new generation storage technology that can store energy in electrochemical form, either in electrochemical form or in the chemical form. And that energy can be converted into electrical energy at any point of time. And this PLI scheme has been approved for achieving manufacturing capacity of 50 gigawatt hour of ACC cell battery storage. जो advanced chemistry cell battery storage है 50 gigawatt hour के manufacturing capacity को achieve करना है, that is the basic objective of the scheme. And these are some of the key points. Remember, each selected ACC battery storage manufacturer, each selected manufacturer would have to commit to set up ACC manufacturing facility of at least 5 gigawatt hour capacity. हर एक manufacturer को कम से कम 5 gigawatt hour capacity की मैन्युफैक्चरिंग फैसिलिटी लगानी पड़ेगी. ईच मैन्युफैक्चरर विल हैव टू सेट अप अ फैसिलिटी दैट कैन प्रोड्यूस अ मिनिमम 5 गीगावाट आर कैपेसिटी ऑफ ACCs एंड दे हैव टू आल्सो इंश्योर अ मिनिमम 60% डोमेस्टिक वैल्यू एडिशन एट द प्रोजेक्ट लेवल विद इन द 5 years, व्हिच मींस द प्रोजेक्ट, व्हिच मींस द प्रोडक्ट शुड हैव 60% डोमेस्टिक, जो उसकी बेसिकली जो उसका असेंबलिंग होगी उसमें 60% डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट होना चाहिए. राइट, there should be 60% products which are made in India which will be used to assemble that particular product, and this has to be achieved within the period of 5 years. The beneficiary firms have to achieve a domestic value addition of at least 25% within the 2 years. ye jo 60% hai ye 5 saal ke liye, lekin agle 2 saal mein kitna karna hai, 25%, and incur the mandatory investment of ₹225 crores per gigawatt hour within 2 years, and this 25% capacity will gradually increase to 60% domestic value addition within 5 years. अगले 5 सालों में 60% domestic value addition होना चाहिए. All right. And now, what are the expected outcomes? What governments expect from this scheme? So, cumulative 50 gigawatt hour of ACC manufacturing facilities in India under the program. Okay. Number two, there will be direct investment of around 45,000 crores in this sector. It will facilitate make in India and demand creation for battery storage in India. It will take care, with the help of this scheme, there will be an import substitution of around rupees 20,000 crore every year. हर साल 20,000 करोड़ का इंपोर्ट सब्स्टिट्यूशन का अनुमान है एंड इट विल आल्सो गिवन इंपीटस टू रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट टू अचीव हायर स्पेसिफिक एनर्जी डेंसिटी एंड साइकल्स इन दिस सेक्टर ऑफ एसीसी ओके सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द एक्सपेक्टेड आउटकम्स दिस यू कैन यूज इन योर सब्जेक्टिव पार्ट ऑफ योर आंसर्स एंड नाउ लेट्स गेट बैक टू द क्वेश्चन यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स आउट ऑफ दीज थ्री द टोटल आउटले फॉर द स्कीम इज रुपीज 20,000 करोड़ नो दैट इज नॉट 20,000 इट्स 18,100 करोड़ विच मीन्स द स्टेटमेंट इज इनकरेक्ट ईच बेनिफिशियरी हैज टू इंश्योर अ मिनिमम 60% डोमेस्टिक वैल्यू एडिशन एट द प्रोजेक्ट लेवल दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट इन द विद इन 5 years एंड इन द फर्स्ट 2 years दिस परसेंटेज शुड बी 25% एंड इट इज एक्सपेक्टेड दैट देर विल बी इम्पोर्ट सब्सटीट्यूशन ऑफ अराउंड रुपीज 20,000 करोड़ एवरी ईयर दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट So second and third statement guys are absolutely correct, which means option B only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 4. In which of the following university or institution an oxygen park has been established using Bima bamboo, which is nothing guys but a special type of bamboo only. ये एक bamboo ही होता है, ठीक है special type का bamboo है और एक special special type of species से बनाया जाता है, okay and The question is in which of the following university or the institution an oxygen park has been established. So this university is guys is the Tamil Nadu Agriculture University where this oxygen park has been established using Bima bamboo. Now what is this oxygen park? So have they installed oxygen cylinders there? No. It is nothing like that. Yahan pe koi oxygen cylinders nahi lagaye gaye hain. In fact 590 Bima bamboo seedlings were planted at the university which will gradually grow. एंड देन प्रोवाइड ऑक्सीजन बेसिकली ये इसका ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑक्सीजन पार्क का कि वहाँ पे 590 बीमा बैम्बू सीडलिंग्स लगाए गए हैं विच विल इवेंचुअली ग्रो एंड देन विल प्रोवाइड ऑक्सीजन इन द एनवायरमेंट ओके सो ऑक्सीजन पार्क में कोई ऐसा कोई बहुत ही रॉकेट साइंस वाला कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं है कोई नया कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं है बेसिकली उन्होंने ट्रीज प्लांटेड करे हैं इकट्ठे बहुत सारे दे हैव प्लांटेड 590 यू नो विच इज अ बिग नंबर एंड दे आर सेइंग दैट ओके वी आर एस्टैब्लिशिंग एन ऑक्सीजन पार्क ओके And talking about Bima bamboo, it is a superior clone from selected from Bambusa balcua, which is a higher biomass yielding species, and it is said to be the best carbon sink to mitigate carbon dioxide emissions. Basically, आपको इस news में से you just have to remember that an oxygen park has been established at the Tamil Nadu Agriculture University using Bima bamboo. That's it. Only one line you have to remember, and this can be asked in your one marker question. It is directly related to the environmental economics. All right. So therefore guys the correct answer is option B Tamil Nadu Agriculture University okay and guys that's it for the session I hope all the questions are clear if you have any doubts you can ask me in the comment section milte hain monday ke session mein goodbye take care and god bless